Good afternoon, ladies and gents. Chris here from DE Razor Shaving with a new shave video. How y'all doing today? Hopefully you're doing pretty good, because I'm doing pretty good too. So I was going to do this one tomorrow. I'm going to do it today though. Tomorrow is Veterans Day though, so thank you to, just want to say thank you to all the veterans. Thank you for your service and all that you do. Yes, so tomorrow is Veterans Day. I was going to do this tomorrow, but I'm like, I'll just do this on Friday. So yeah, I'm wearing camo. Got the camo G-Shock on, so yeah. Yeah, veterans rock. Alright, so what are we doing today? We're doing a shave, and I got a lot of new stuff in this one. So, first off, brush we're going to be going with. This is, picked this up a couple weeks ago, and yeah, it's really, really awesome. So this is Chisel and Hound Pueblo brush that I knotted with a 26mm Richman Shaving Ultra Luxe. Look at that beauty. That looks so cool. It's copper resin. Copper resin mingles with translucent turquoise in what has become my best-selling color combination. That's Rob talking, not me. So yes, you got the copper resin, and it flows into here all the way down. You can even see it in here. It looks really, really flipping awesome. Like, this is so amazingly cool. You can check that out. The sparkles are like a purplish color. And the photo and video does not do it. Yeah, you can see a little bit of the purple there. It looks so, so awesome. So that is the brush we're going to be using. So here's a couple pics of it. I tried to do get real good detail on it and a little short video too. So check it out. Okay, so here she is in the sun. Let's see if I can capture it really good. Yeah, hi. You can see me in the reflection right there. Very, very cool though. It just shimmers. Like, it looks way, way better in person. There's like purpley sparkles in there. Like in hand, it just looks so, so, so good. Copper. Richman Shaving knot that I put in there. Ultralux. Yeah, just gonna try it. Yeah, sun. Absolutely amazing. Awesome, awesome work, Rob. Very, very cool, dude. Pretty cool, right? Yeah, the video and the photo does no justice. And it's in, when it's in your hand and you look at it, it's awesome. So I got it soaking in the That'll Be Shaving mug. I've got distilled water in there. It's 30 seconds in the microwave. So we're just going to let that sit while we do more talking and flapping of the lip. Pre-shave, we're going to go with Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements Ice Tube 2.0. That'll be our pre-shave today. DE Razor, something new I picked up. You guys see me use the aggressive one. This is actually the medium one. This is from Henson Shaving. I picked this one up from the Razor Company. This is the AL13 Copper Colored Plus Plus Medium Razor. Ooh, I got the aggressive one. I did have the old medium one, so... this is the new medium one that they upgraded in for everything. So corners are gone. Everything is now beveled, not square. And got the little indented little grips right here. Grippy handle. Bigger, beefier handle. Yeah, so I want to give the medium a try. I was thinking too, not in this video, but I was thinking maybe I'll do like a side-by-side with the medium one and with the aggressive one. Just to see if there is any difference. But I haven't used this yet, so. You see it's plus plus. Maybe the camera can't see right there in the glow. Masks were made to hide the glow. And it's got the tungsten thing on there. So yeah. It's hard to start things over. Damn good song. Blade we're going with. Like what I said the last few videos, we're doing the Tatara again. This is the Tatara DE Blade. And this is going to be its third use. Third use. Tatara DE Blade. Last couple shaves have been really good. Except for that bloodbath that I had right here. I don't know why that happened. Anyway, yeah, we'll get that loaded up in there. You can feel the fire around us all the time. Yeah. What the hell have I? Okay, medium. We'll see how the medium goes. This is 4 days worth of growth. I did a shave on Monday. So yeah, today is Friday, 12:04 in the afternoon. Yes, so more talking points. Soap we're gonna be going with. I picked this one up from Razor Emporium Last time I went down there. Never used anything by Noble Otter. They have several Noble Otter scents there, like on the shelf and on the website. This one spoke to me, though. This one I like. There's another, the Neon Sun. That one smells pretty good, too. But I picked up this one, and it's in French. It looks like it says, the Noir et Vanille. No, that's not how you say it. It's got the little enye above the E. So the way you pronounce this is, in French, Te Noir et Vanille. That's how you say it. Black tea and vanilla. So yes, scent profile. Semperfy. Bergamot, loose black tea, jasmine, strawberry, and vanilla. So, this is off the website. This is not me speaking. Te Noir et Vanille, which translates to black tea and vanilla, is what we envision a late night cup of tea in Paris smells like. Off the tub, you pick up a beautiful note, pick up beautiful notes of loose black tea. After lathering, you start to notice the subtle florals and citrus from the jasmine and bergamot, all while engaged with a sweet and warm vanilla, perfect for anyone who loves tea. I get the loose tea up front, and it's sweet, but it's not like off the tub. Yeah, I get the black tea. And then you get the other, like a sweeter notes. I don't know what bergamot smells like, so I couldn't say what straight bergamot smells like, but I get a little bit of, sorry, a little bit of a vanilla, but yeah, black tea right up front. And yeah, this one smelled really good at Razor Emporium, so I grabbed it, picked it out. So, I'm gonna get it loaded up in a potato bowl, pre-shave on, and I'll be right back. All right, I'm back, pre-shave on. Pre-shave's already on, yes. Save time. Save time. Take time with a wounded hand. Ooh. Ooh, lathered up really, really easy. Yeah, I did use the distilled water today. Yeah. So, yeah, very, it lathered up easy. Did not take much water either. Did not seem like a very thirsty kind of soap. Some soap, CK6, you gotta use a lot of water. Yeah. I was gonna blend in with the camo. Gray camo. Black and white camo. Yes, it does. I got the black tea up front. Jasmine, I'm not sure what it smells like, but it is, it's black tea, it's sweet, it's like the vanilla, a little bit of a strawberry, it smells really good. And this is the one I picked up from Razor Emporium. I said, I think it's called Neon Sun, that's another one I smelled down there, I thought it smelled pretty good. I grabbed this one instead. I like heavy shaves. All right, that's good enough. Good enough. Henson AL13 ++ medium razor, copper color. Got from the Razor Emporium. No, Razor Company. I got it from the Razor Company. I get those two mixed up when I say them. Copper colored, medium, and this is a third use Tatara DE blade. The Razor Company, Razor Emporium. The Razor Company, Razor Emporium. Practice. Pass number one. 4 days of growth. Gone. Mows it right down. So for all you spec tech guys, here is the difference between the AL13 medium +++ and the AL13 +++ aggressive. Here's all the, like, the stats, if you guys want to like read up on that, if that interests you. I know some people like that stuff. Blade gap, blade exposure. So far, this does not seem as aggressive as the aggressive one. Go figure. This is the medium one, though. I don't know if I would get the light one. That's just me personally. Maybe if you had to shave every day, but I don't shave every day. Ding. So how y'all doing? You guys got planned for this weekend? All you veterans out there? I did that. Yeah, this one does not seem as aggressive as the aggressive one. Kind of liking this a little bit more than the aggressive one. You can feel the fire. I don't know why that song's in my head. It just popped in there. Because you're a weirdo, Chris. That's why. That's me. Cool is that Alice in Chains song. I think that was, I remember right, it's off the last Action Hero soundtrack. And whenever it came out, God, I can't remember what year it came out, 93? Maybe even earlier than that. But at the end, the guitar player Jerry Cantrell, at the very end, he's singing, like he's singing at the very end. But they do a close-up of his eye on the camera like that. And his contact is like a yellow smiley face. I wanted those so bad when I was a kid. I was like, oh, where can I pick those up at? They looked awesome. All right, let's go for a two-second pass. You can feel the fire around us all the time. Unique voice, too. God. Lane Staley had such an amazing voice. I feel so alone, good enough to think about their bones. Ah. For all you musician fans, if you guys didn't know this, you guys know the band Godsmack? They actually got their name from an Alice in Chains song. That is how that band got that name. And we all know what Godsmack means. Yeah. You don't want to be doing that. You don't want to be doing that stuff. Yeah. Woo-woo. Scary on the wall. Scary. This is nice. I'm liking this more than the aggressive one. Four days gross, but I can tell that it is. I can tell just by shaving with it, not looking at the like stats or the blade gap or yada yada. It is milder than the aggressive one. Not by a lot. But it is milder. I think I'm liking this one more than the aggressive one. Not just me. It's like with the aggressive one, it's gone. It shaves it right off. This is a little bit more passes, but I don't mind. Yeah, we're good. And that's close too. No nicks, no cuts, no weepers in the problem area, nothing. That was a damn good shave. So, yeah, I'm digging the medium one. So, yeah, very close, very efficient. Nothing. That was a good one. All right, clean up in the beer buck. I'm the man in the box. Shaving on my channel. Yeah, keep it at PG. You know what he really says. All right, very close. Very efficient, very smooth, sticky smooth. No cuts, no weepers, no nicks. I think I'm liking the medium more, a little bit more than aggressive. But like I said, I'm going to do, I don't know when, I want to do a side-by-side. I want to do the medium one on one side, and I want to do like the aggressive one on one side. What the hell was that? Anyways, okay. PA Allen Black. Going with the Allen Black. Going with the Allen Black. That is great. He feeds us chocolate cake. I know a lot of you won't know what that's from. But, Urban. My parents, I think they still have them in the living room. They had these records, 12-inch records of Bill Cosby, I think it was. Oh, damn, dropped that. And he used to do, like, spoken word, I guess. The thunder, or what is it? The chicken heart. Dun, 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 dun. Why is there air? Yeah, I don't know why that popped in my head, though, yeah. Dad is great. He feeds us chocolate cake. No sting at all. Like, no zing, no nothing. Yeah, good. Ooh, pat dry. Pat dry. All right, so, haven't even opened this yet. And it is Noble Otter Soap Company. Tan Noir et Vanille. Crazy vanilla is the same as, it almost sounds the same in French and Spanish. So, in French... vanilla. Vanilla. That's in French. But in Spanish, the V is almost pronounced like a B. So in French, it would be vanilla. In French, it would sound, or in Spanish, it would sound like vanilla. It's different. Vanilla. Got that B accent to it, yeah. Bzzz. Let's see how it goes. Black tea, yeah. Then the other stuff. I get the black tea right up front though, but see how the dry down goes. It's sweet, citrusy, yes. Ooh, that's nice, different. The soap, I get the black tea, like straight up the black tea. This is more of like a citrusy type scent. You get the black tea up front, you put it on, but then it's like, is bergamot citrus? Yeah, it's citrusy. It's not really florally, like a floral you would think. That's nice. That's good. That smells different from the soap. The soap is like, I get the black tea right up front off the soap. Yeah, the soap, see how much I scraped. I get the black tea, the splash. I get more of like this citrusy, citrusy notes that are in it. I believe that's bergamot. Start to subtle floral notes, citrus from the jasmine and bergamot. Okay, so jasmine and bergamot are a citrusy smell. That's probably what I'm picking up. It smells good. I don't get the vanilla off the splash at all. I do get like a citrusy scent. That smells nice. That's cool. I'm glad I picked that up. All right, that's it. So recap of what we used. Today we use from Noble Otter Soap Soap Company, Tan Noir et Vanille. Yes, that's the splash. We use the PA Allen Block. We use, what did we use? Phoenix Artist and Accoutrements Ice Tube Pre-Shave Soap 2.0. We use that. That over there, set that over there. We use my Chisel and Hound Pueblo brush with a Rich Man Shaving 26mm Ultra Lux. Not that I nodded in there. Awesome. Look at that. Like, it's so good. I've been wanting one of these for a while. I finally, like, I'm going to grab one. Yeah. Got the Ultra Lux knot. I did put conditioner on there after I cleaned up everything, and there it is. Very cool. Awesome, awesome brush. Go check out Chisel and Hound. He's got some cool stuff. Rob. The eraser we went with. We went with the Henson AL13++ medium razor in the copper color. And the blade we have in there is a third use Tatara DE blade. So we're going to go for a fourth use on it. Next shave. So yeah. No nicks, no cuts. No, I think I like the medium. From those two shaves, I like the medium a little bit more than the aggressive one. It works a little bit more better for me. I mean, no nicks, no cuts. Yeah, it was pretty damn good. All right, put edible. No pick today. Didn't use that. We soaked it in my leather be shaving coffee mug. Always look down to see if I'm forgetting anything. So, star of the show today, I picked up from Razor Emporium. This is Noble Otter Soap Company, made in the USA. Te Noir et Vanille. That's what that is. Black tea and vanilla. It's good scent. If you like, if that's up your alley in your wheelhouse, then check it out. So there's the notes. Bergamot, loose black tea, jasmine, strawberry, and vanilla. Oh, that's white people. Vanilla. It's got vanilla. It has vanilla in it. Yeah, it smells good. I recommend if you want a tea type scent. The only other tea one that I have is Luther Dave. That's more of an Earl Grey tea though. This is a black tea. So, but very cool. Got the Noble Otter on there. It's Distinguished Gentleman Otter. That is it. That is the shave of the day, ladies and gents. And it was a damn good one. Yeah, that was a good one. All right, so tomorrow's Veterans Day. Like I said, thank you to all you veterans out there. And yeah, thank you for your service and for all. Thank you for your service and all that you do. Yeah. So if you guys be set, if you guys celebrate Veterans Day tomorrow, I'll be hanging the flag out tomorrow when I wake up in the morning. So yeah, I got more to come. I got more to come. Yeah. So that's it. Be safe. And yeah, I'll see you, ladies and gents, soon. So hope you, ladies and gents, have a good day, good week, good shaves, more to come, and see you, ladies and gents, soon. Bye.